Hello students, today we are going to discuss Unit 4th, Topic Demand Forecasting in Supply Chain Management. The first question which comes in our mind, what is forecasting? Forecasting is simply the prediction or estimation of future event. Demand forecasting is divided into two categories. First one is qualitative, second one is quantitative. In qualitative, there are several methods, that is survey method, Delphi method, Salesforce opinion method. In this qualitative method, there is no numeric data is available and the calculation is based on the human judgment. And in quantitative methods, we have some data, numeric data, and we use some statistical tools to calculate or to forecast for the next year. And in quantitative method, first method is simple moving average, weighted moving average, and exponential smoothing method, and one more extrapolative method. In this video, we are going to discuss only these three methods. Now, let's start with the simple moving average method. In simple moving average method, it is assumed that average is a good estimator of future behavior, and the formula of the simple moving average is FT is equals to 80 minus 1 plus 80 minus 2 plus 80 minus 3 and so on divided by n, where FT is the forecast for the coming period, n is the number of period, 80 is the actual demand in the past period. This can be better understood with the help of example. In this example, we have data of 12 weeks and we have to calculate forecast for the 13th week, and by 3-week moving average method and 6-week moving average method. So firstly, we calculate the forecast for 13th period through 3-week moving average method. In this 3-week moving average method, we take the value of 3 weeks starting from the last, that is 12th week, 11th week and 10th week, and we simply add the three values and divide it by 3, and the forecast for the 13th is 851. And for 6 week moving average method, we take 6 values starting from the last, that is 12, 11, 10, 9, 8 and 7th. We add all the values and divide it by 6. The 13th week forecast is 842.166. So it is very clear, if we calculate or need a accurate forecast, we need more data. So this is one of the limitation of this method. There are two limitation, or we can say two challenges of simple moving average method. First one is that we require more data for forecast with less error. So for this, we store more data and it cost very high. This is one of the limitation of this method. Second is, we are giving equal weight to all the past period, which is practically not possible. And the next updated method of this moving average is weighted moving average. And in this method, we overcome the above two set problems. In this weighted moving average method, we assign the weight. We assign the weight of past periods, and with the help of these weights, we differentiate the past period. And the formula of this weighted moving average is FT is equals to W1 80 minus 1 plus W2 80 minus 2 plus W3 80 minus 3 and so on. And there is a one condition, the sum of all the weights is equal to 1. And this can also be understood with the help of this example. In this example, there are 4 weeks and we have demand till 3 week, 3rd week, and we have to calculate or we forecast the demand for the 4th week. And on the left side, the weights are also given. T minus 1 is equals to 0.5, T minus 2 is equals to 0.3, T minus 3 is equals to 0.3. And according to this method, weighted moving average method, we assign the highest to the most recent period. So we assign this 0.5 to the 3rd period, 0.3 for the 2nd period, and 0.2 for the 1st period, because we know the last or most recent period has a very more impact on the forecast value. That's why we assign the highest weight to the most recent period, and the solution is this. And the forecast for the fourth period is 693.4. Okay. And the next or third method is exponential smoothing method. In this method, we continuously try to update the base value, and the updated base value become the forecast for the next period. Let's have a look on this graph. We have a time on x-axis and demand on y-axis, and this dotted line represents the base, or we can say level, and this dark line or fluctuating line represents the actual demand, and this arrow represents the randomness. And in this method, we try to minimize this randomness, we try to minimize these fluctuations and create a new base, or we can say update a new base, and this updated base become the forecast for the next period. And the formula of this exponential smoothing is new base is equals to previous base plus alpha, new demand minus previous demand, that is in bracket. This new base is represented by ST is equals to ST minus 1 plus alpha in bracket DT minus ST minus 1. This alpha represents the smoothing constant. Suppose this ST, we calculate this ST for January 2020. This January 2020 ST represents the forecast for February 2020. Okay. And one more thing which I want to explain, that alpha. The alpha range from 0 to 1. Okay. Suppose we take alpha is equals to 0, then this whole equation, or we can say this ST is equals to ST minus 1. If we take alpha is equals to 0, this represents we are neglecting all the fluctuations. In this condition, we are neglecting all the fluctuations, because we assume that all the fluctuations are temporary in nature. That's why we neglect all the fluctuations. If alpha is equals to 1, then this equation or ST is equals to DT. In this condition, we consider all the fluctuation. In this situation, we assume that all the fluctuations are permanent in nature. That's why we consider all the fluctuations in alpha is equals to 1. Okay. And the last note, lower value of alpha gives more smoothing effect. Thank you, student.